Hey everybody, welcome back and thank you for stopping by to check out another video here on the channel. Today, I'm going to talk about some chain maintenance. I'm going to start off discussing the intervals between chain maintenance, including the cleaning, the lubrication, the inspections that I perform on my motorcycles. It's an iteration that has always worked well for me. Of course, you know, it might be something different for you and your motorcycle, and that is entirely up to you. I want to talk a little bit about the parts and the equipment that you will need to perform the chain maintenance. I want to go through the process and kind of just show what I do when I'm performing chain maintenance on the motorcycles that I've had. There will be a little bit of this that is specific to the BMW F900 XR, simply because that is the motorcycle that is currently housed in my garage. But the process itself is universal to any chain-driven motorcycle. So, again, thanks for stopping by to check out the video. Let's get after it. All right, the first thing I want to cover is the intervals or the iterations between performing chain maintenance. I used to be someone who would say that I wanted to clean and lube a chain about every 300 to 400 miles. I'm now more in the wheelhouse of saying that I want to take care of it about every 400 to 500 miles. Now, on the F900 XR, since I bought this motorcycle new, I did kind of revert back to old habits temporarily. I did a cleaning and lubrication of this chain at 300 miles, again at 600 miles shortly before I took the motorcycle in for its first service. Then I went to, 1,000 miles before I did the next chain maintenance. And right now I'm sitting just shy of 1400 miles. So looks like I'm going to be in that 400 mile, window. Again, I think that 400 to 500 miles is enough for me to frequently have an opportunity to inspect the sprockets, inspect the chain, inspect the wheels, kind of get down and look at some things that I normally wouldn't see unless I'm going hands-on with performing this maintenance. So I'm sitting at around 1,400 miles now. Again, about every 400 to 500 miles, you're gonna wanna clean and lube this chain. In my mind, if you ride your motorcycle less frequently and you need to get down there and actually do some maintenance on it, make sure you're not dealing with any sort of corrosion or whatnot, then by all means, feel free to adapt that window to what makes sense for you. All right, two things real quick before we get into the process. You want to make sure that you can lift this rear wheel, if at all possible. If not, you will still be able to perform chain maintenance on your motorcycle. You're just going to have to roll the motorcycle forward and backwards to expose the entire length of chain so you can properly clean and lubricate it all. If you can get it up, make your life easier. Also, take the bike around the block a couple of times, get a couple miles on it, heat everything up, make sure that the sprocket and the chain are warm. It will also make this job a lot easier. So in this case, got a couple miles on the motorcycle and I have it up on a rear stand. Now, first things first, after you get ready to actually perform the maintenance here, make sure you've got some sort of cardboard or plastic laid down. You're going to get a lot of stuff dripping off of this chain when you clean it, and you don't want a pool of nastiness just kind of building up in your driveway or in your garage. So put something down to catch a lot of the stuff that's going to drip off this chain. Get yourself a pair of gloves, can be shop gloves, can be a pair of disposable gloves, whatever works for you. Make sure you've got the proper bits that you're going to need to remove the screws for the chain guard on the F900 XR. I'm going to need a T30. Also, get a driver and a ratchet to utilize with these bits. For cleaning the chain, I use kerosene. I put some kerosene in a spray bottle, and it gives me a chance to go ahead and soak this chain down really well. The top and the bottom of the chain, the inside, the outside, however you want to refer to it. Kerosene will not damage the O-rings or the X-rings on this chain. Little rubber rings in between the links. So that's one of the reasons I use the kerosene. Another reason is just because it simply works. I've been using kerosene for years, and it's really effective as a chain cleaner. If you're in Europe and you're looking for kerosene, it's called paraffin in Europe. So by all means, just know kerosene or paraffin, put it in a spray bottle, you should be good to go. I also use a brush that has some plastic bristles. Again, that's to make sure that they don't damage the O-rings or the X-rings on these modern motorcycle chains. Once I'm done cleaning the chain with the brush, I will take a rag and I go back in and just kind of wipe down, get off all that residue, make sure I'm paying attention to the sprocket, which you can see has quite a bit of residue and buildup on it there. So we're going to get that off. And then for lubricating the chain, I'm going to use one of three things. I mean, I'm showing you these so you know that you don't have to have a hard, fast, lubrication that you use for your chain. Gear oil, it works fantastic. I use gear oil quite frequently. I also like this product made by Maxima, a synthetic chain guard. And I also like the Lucas Oil Chain Lube. So, all of these products are fantastic. They all work well. You get a little less fling off coming from something like the gear oil or even this synthetic chain guard by Maxima. I have less kind of fling coming off from either of those compared to the Lucas Oil Chain Lube. So I'm going to use the Maxima Chain Guard for this video, but again, all three products will serve you well. And then the other thing I would recommend is that you get yourself some sort of a stool so you can stay comfortable while you're doing this. So let's get into the process, shall we? All right, so first things first, we're going to want to take off the chain guard so we can actually get to the chain as easy as possible for the sake of cleaning and lubricating the chain. Now, on the F900XR, there's a total of seven screws that have to come off. You've got three that are on this cover or this plate that sits right behind the gear lever. You have two that sit just in front of the rear wheel, right behind the monoshock. You've got another one that's sitting on the swing arm, and the seventh and final screw actually sits right in here, which is the only reason we've got to take those three off so we can remove that cover. So make sure you've identified all of the points on your chain guard that need to be removed. Go ahead and get the chain guard taken off. And, then let's take a look at the chain. All right, the chain guard has been removed, and now you can see that you have unobstructed access to a full length of the chain here, to make it easier for getting this thing cleaned up. So, it might be a good idea also to mark your chain like I have here, so you have an indication of where the chain starts and or ends to make sure you're getting full rotations and cycles. I also wanted to point out, you can see that even with regular chain maintenance, there's a lot of debris or crud that just builds up on here. Again, this has only been about 400 miles, and there's stuff caked on here. The sprocket has a lot of stuff built up on it. The swing arm does. I'm looking at the wheel while I'm down here, just making sure there's nothing that stands out that needs attention. But obviously, it's really dirty. So this chain maintenance gives you a chance to notice these things, look at these things, and make sure that you're taking care of your equipment. If this is what it'll look like after 400 miles, then you can imagine if you ignore it, what is going on and how much it will diminish the life of your equipment. So make sure you take care of your equipment, folks. And speaking of which, let's get that underway. Okay, so I'm not going to record this whole process just for the sake of not making this video, 25, 30 minutes long. But I'm going to find where I started. Or where I marked my chain, okay? And then what I'm going to do is I am going to spray the chain down with the kerosene, making sure that I get at least 2 full passes on this. I'm not too worried if I get any of this on the wheel, the swing arm, or even the tire. If you get it on the tire, make sure you wipe it off, and if you're concerned about it, take it easy when you first take off. You know, it's a good rule of practice. I try to keep things off the tire, but not that big of a deal. So once I get that sprayed down, I'm going to take the grunge brush. I'm just going to stick it on there, okay? And then I'm going to rotate this tire. Now, when I'm on the top of the tire, I'm rotating forward, right? I don't want anything to get stuck between the sprocket and the chain. I just want to rotate this forward. Now, once I've scrubbed the top of this, which again, I'm not going to record the whole thing, I will move down and I will spray some kerosene down here. And then down here, I'm going to rotate the wheel backwards, right? Again, I don't want anything potentially being pulled into the sprocket and the chain here. So, you know, you want to make sure you spray the top generously, then spray the bottom. And then, again, you're going to take your brush, just kind of wedge it in there, right? Okay. Make sure that you are giving several full rotations. Once that is done, then you're going to take the cloth that you have and you're going to wipe it down, right? So this way, when you're doing that, make sure you're letting the cloth get in between the links onto those rollers, and do a really good job of getting the dirt and debris out of the middle. And then repeat the process down here on the bottom. You'll see that there's an awful lot of stuff that drips off, which is exactly why you want to make sure you've got the cardboard or something sat down there. So anyway, yeah, let me pause the video and we'll get back in here in a minute. Okay, so I have completed scrubbing this top and bottom, saturated it really well with kerosene. Now I am taking the cloth. I've already wiped it down, but I'm now going to take the cloth and get onto the rollers right in the middle of the chain. And I'm going to give this a rotation and kind of let those rollers get wiped down on both sides. So this will take a minute, you know, but not that big of a deal. And, you know, for me, it's worth it. I'm probably a little more meticulous on some of these things than I need to be, but, you know, again, I'm trying to take care of the equipment that is taking care of me and want to make sure that I'm doing the best job I can to care for the investment I have in this motorcycle. Keep it running as optimal as I can, so helps keep me safe, keeps the people around me safe, keeps anybody that I'm carrying safe, the whole nine yards. So anyway, now the other thing I'm going to do here is I'm going to take my towel and I'm going to put it right where the sprocket meets the chain, and I'm going to put some pressure on the sprocket as I'm doing this, and I'm going to give this a good wipe as well to get off any of the additional grime that may be there that was visible very clearly in our before video when I started this process. So get the sprocket cleaned up, right? I also want to go ahead and clean off the wheel. Give this a good rotation here, making sure that I'm not putting anything down in this way, because down here, since I am rotating the wheel forward, get the wheel cleaned up, and it gives me a chance also to take a look at all of the spokes as I'm doing this to make sure I don't have any sort of a crack that I didn't know about, that I don't have any damage to the wheel itself. And I also now have an opportunity to take a peek at the tire very well, make sure that I don't have anything on the tire that needs attention. And as you can see, as I wipe this down, what this looked like when I was taking the chain guard off compared to what it looks like now is really a night and day difference. Okay, so once I have gone through, wiped down the whole wheel, looked at the spokes, I'm also going to go ahead and take a second, because I can't access this part of the swing arm when I'm cleaning the motorcycle since the chain guard is in the way. So I'm going to go ahead, wipe this down a little bit while I have a rag with some kerosene on it. Okay. I'm going to put that rag out of the way, and then I'm going to get a hold of the chain guard that, or the chain lube that I'm using today. Okay. I'm going to give this a good shake. It's got a little red applicator tip. Looks like a really thin straw. Now, I want to find where I've got this marked. Okay. Let's get to that spot. All right, so right here, and I'm just going to spray this right down the middle of the chain, starting with where the markings are there, right? Rotating the wheel, not too incredibly fast, but you know, you certainly don't want to go too slow, right? And I want to give this a full rotation of the chain. Okay, so there it is. Now, I'm gonna go back, I'm gonna grab my rag, and I'm gonna go on the wheel. Okay, I'm gonna clean off some of that extra lubrication there, right? And then I'm gonna come down to the inside of the chain as well. I can see that's where my mark is, and I'm gonna do the same thing here. All right. Okay, so I'll give it a rotation. Now I'm gonna let that sit, all right, for a couple of minutes, and then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my rag. Okay, once that's been sitting for a couple of minutes, I'm going to put my rag back on this chain, and I'm going to rotate the wheel forward. So, tell you what, I'm going to go ahead and do that now, actually. So, I'm not putting any pressure on this, by the way. I'm just rotating this forward, and I'm getting off any excess that might be on the outside of the chain. The stuff that is on the inside of the chain where it meets the sprocket, I'm not touching. And I want to do it on this sprocket, so I'm not actually rotating the little wheels in between the links. I'm just making sure that I have any excess wiped off. So that is the process for taking care of your chain here. You can see that the sprocket looks much better than it did. You can see the chain is very clean. There's none of that built-up grime sitting in there. This is going to extend the life of the equipment. Really simple process to follow. Every 400 to 500 miles, just take some time, get this done, and you know, maybe you'll actually even find it a tad bit enjoyable. So Thanks a lot for checking out another video here, and as always, ride safe.